I'll fill you in if you fill me.
Feathers flew the chickens, two officials didn't know what to do. Young boys chased hens, escaped fist fights between tightly laced funeral grounds.
I remember the sound most of all. A wide, warm well.
This program is funded by the Minnesota Arts and Cultural Heritage Fund, with money from the vote of the people of Minnesota on November 4th, 2008. And by the members of Prairie Public.
Can't see in front of my feet. I'm tripping over a diamond ring, and I don't pick it up. Can't see in front of my nose. I'm pulling at a door that says closed, and I don't stop. Lucky for me, yeah. Lucky for me, yeah. Lucky for me, you can see. Can't hear it when angels speak. One said, you're the one for me. I must have missed her. Can't say what's on my mind. Can barely say it out the time. I can only whisper. Lucky for me, yeah. Lucky for me, yeah. Lucky for me, you can hear. I always turn the wrong way. I always pick the wrong card. If it can be easy, I'll find a way to make it hard. You must be sending your luck my way. Can't really deal with risk. I always order the same dish, even though I don't like it. I'm getting sick of this food. Time to order something new. And you're on special. Lucky for me, yeah. Lucky for me, oh yeah. Lucky for me, you taste lucky.
I'm from New York City, and I moved to rural West Central Minnesota. And though I moved for a man, when I wrote the following song, I figured it was probably time to leave the big city. This song is called Concrete.
Concrete walkways to concrete cells, concrete edges to our hollow shells, concrete wrapped around my feet. Concrete, concrete scepter, concrete crown. I wish I knew how not to drown in my concrete boat on a concrete sea. I'm a concrete refugee. I'm not looking for something so hard and fast. I'm looking to stay just to make it last. I'm looking for someone to walk with me on the concrete waters of the concrete sea. Concrete mold around my soul, too hard to move or too scared to let go. Concrete boots, concrete gloves, concrete divider between our love. It's the concrete sound of a concrete heart, buried to hide its concrete scars. Concrete wagons circle empty rooms, concrete drums beating concrete tattoos. I'm not looking for something so hard and fast, or looking to stay just to make it last. I'm looking for someone to walk with me on the concrete waters of the concrete sea. Concrete ruffles on concrete beds, concrete muffles what they may have said. Concrete shingles on a concrete roof, concrete
concrete makes us fireproof. It's the concrete tempest on a rock hard sea. Concrete cementing you and me. Concrete glistens from too much rain. Concrete leads us home again. I'm not looking for something so hard and fast, or looking to stay just to make it last. I'm looking for someone to walk with me on the concrete waters of the concrete. The concrete waters of the concrete. The concrete waters of the concrete sea. I have this little habit. I love to write songs about oddballs and rather unique events that happen in history. And I have a whole collection of songs about people and events that I like to think of as too fascinating for the history books. This next song is about a man named Herman Fink from Wadena, Minnesota, who opened a grocery store in town during the Depression, which was a terrible time to open a grocery store because no one had any money. So he decided that the way to bring people into his store was to come up with a marketing plan. And the marketing plan he came up with was to offer three gifts for three Saturdays in a row. And what he chose to be the free gift and the chaos that ensued in Wadena are the subject of this next song. Herman Fink was new in town. He built a grocery on the corner and settled down to bring in customers and make it pay. He offered free gifts for three Saturdays. At first, people gathered in groups and pairs, and the back alley crates climbed high in the air. When it was time, he asked all to stand by, and 100 hens rained down from the sky. Feathers flew the chickens. Two officials didn't know what to do. Young boys chased hens, escaped fist fights between tightly laced funeral frows, smashed to the ground. Two car windshields were knocked out. Men and ladies fussing, gentlemen fussing, and every bird waste was everywhere mussing. That week, Fink saw the town's ire rise. He decided he needed a different prize to replace the hens from the week before. He chose a bird to be a better score. The customers thought they knew what to expect. They came with boxes to collect, but leghorn cockerels can run and fly, and pretty soon everything went awry. Feathers flew the rooster, two officials watched them take to roost. People chased to find the birds, to find those birds and get a taste. The very next morning on every store awning, cockerels dropped birdie warnings. Fink said people shouldn't fuss, but too many feathers had been mussed, and the people called for a Herman Fink bust. Though gentlemen sniggered and the ladies it triggered, a new chicken safety brigade. Herman, disgraced, tried to save face and gave up his bird-based scheme. Birds cooed and cawed, Fink hemmed and hawed, and finally compromised on beach balls for the last week. On the third Saturday, Fink let down his fans when from his roof it rained beach balls instead of bird contraband. No feathers flew, it was balls Fink threw. Officials had nothing to do. No birds misplaced, and fist fights no trace, and no one left Wadena disgraced. No ladies fussing or gentlemen cussing, and no one wiping off bird mussing. Wadena settled back down to be a quiet town where boring is better than too many birds around. But we can still remember. Feathers flew the chickens, two officials watched them take to roost. Young boys chased hens, escaped fist fights between tightly laced. Mrs. Brown smashed to the ground, two car windshields were knocked out. Ladies fussing, gentlemen cussing, and bird waste was everywhere mussing. Now Adina settled back down to be a quiet town where boring is better than too many birds around. I love to write shows that include my songs about oddballs in history. And the song about Herman Fink is in two of those shows. One is called Minnesota's Ordinarily Unsung Concert, about Minnesota characters. And the second show is called Oy Vey is Jewish for Oofta, about Jewish immigrants to the rural upper Midwest. This next song is also from Oy Vey's Jewish for Oofta, and it's about a Jewish-Russian immigrant named Rachel Kaloff who came to North Dakota. Her story is very unique because she came as a mail-order bride.
A young Jewish girl in the Russian powder keg, abandoned by my father. My mother was dead. unwanted but to care for my brother's five. I took another woman's passport for a one-way ride from a hard life to a new land. I became a mail order bride. First saw my husband on the New York dock, come to take me to his North Dakota farm. Separate berths on the endless train, we disembarked on a featureless plane. Hard land for a new life as a mail order bride. The women sang, men beat time on tin pans. My mother-in-law put a flour sack over my head. On my wedding day, I was blind. At least they couldn't see me cry. New land, same hard life for a mail order bride. One room winter shack with my husband, parents, brother, and wife. Chickens under the bed, calf in the corner, cruel cold from the cracks. 100 winds couldn't relieve the stench. I prayed to gray skies for winter to end. Hard land for a new life, just another mail order bride. The women sang, men beat time on tin pans. My mother-in-law put a flour sack over my head. On my wedding day, I was blind. At least they couldn't see me cry. New land, same hard life. Hard life in a new land. Hard land for a new as a mail order bride.
I read a memoir of a man who had been a chaplain in the Yankee Army during the Civil War, and he was captured and was in a prisoner of war camp. And in his memoir, he told the story of these women who would come up to the prison, and around a prison, there was a line called the deadline, and the deadline was where beyond which a prisoner would be shot dead. Now, these Southern women would come up to this deadline with food and clothing for prisoners who were barely being fed and were very cold. And they were doing this for enemy prisoners. And the chaplain surmised that the reason these Southern women were helping these men was because they had loved ones, husbands and brothers and sons and fathers, who were in prison camps up north. And they were hoping against hope that the women up north would do the same for their loved ones. This song is about that, and it's dedicated to all of those people willing to cross enemy lines for the sake of humanity. This is called Deadline.
Have five daughters and a little to spare. Since my husband's been a prisoner down there, I know he's hungry somewhere. So for others I care. If he sends me letters, they don't arrive. But they tell me he's still alive, and that they'll treat him well till the Union prevails. Here, soldier, take my hand. I'll give you all that I can spare. All I ask is your prayer that your woman will do the same. for my man. I walk up and down the deadline each day. Some days they order me away, and I make my retreat just beyond their beat. I hide my bundle under my shawl. I wait to hear the captain's call, and then I sneak in to help whom I can. Here, soldier, take my hand. I'll give you all that I can spare. All I ask is your prayer that your woman will do the same for my man. How low we make our enemies fall. They're only men after all. Hungry and frail, ragged and pale. My husband could be yours. Your son could be mine. So please be gentle and kind out there on your deadline. Here, soldier, take my hand. I'll give you all that I can spare. All I ask is your prayer that your woman will do the same. Your woman will do the same. Woman will do the same for my man. It's not about the Ferris wheel or the way his hand holds hers. It's not the wind at the top of the world or the stars that feel so close. It's not the way he leans in to whisper in her ear or how she looks at him, saying nothing, the meaning clear. It's not about them, it's about me. It's not how the crowd sounds far away from high above. It's not the scent of cotton candy laced with ocean salt. It's not about the room to spread out on a bench made tight for two, or how the wind feels colder without someone next to you. It's not about that, it's about me. When it's up for them, it's down for me. If I could stop, I'd swing so free. It's a peaceful view I see when it's far away from me. It's not about the bumper cars that crash but never meet. It's not about the flashing arcade or the kids who keep getting beat. It's not about the hollow music piped in from the carousel, or the way I wish they'd all go somewhere else, which is really not about them, it's about me. When it's up for them, it's down for me. If I could stop, I'd swing so free. It's a peaceful view I see when it's far away from me. When it's up for them, it's down for me. If I could stop, I'd swing so free. It's a peaceful view I see when it's far away from me.
Another song from my show, Oy Vey is Jewish for Oofta, is about a really interesting situation that happened when Jewish immigrants moved into Devil's Lake, North Dakota. The Jewish immigrants in the late 19th and early 20th century had just come, and they hadn't yet had a chance to build a synagogue as a place of worship. And the High Holy Days were coming around, and all the Jewish farmers from miles around were needing a place to worship. And they made an arrangement with the Devil's Lake community to borrow the county courthouse as the synagogue, which they continued for a few years in a row. And I loved the idea of a courthouse becoming a synagogue in cooperation among the community. And so this song is about that. This is called Courthouse Synagogue.
I remember the sound most of all, a wide, warm well of song, Hebrew prayers in the jewelry box, lawyer's table in a white tablecloth. The rabbi spoke from the judge's bench. The Torah stood in the witness stand. The sound of Hebrew prayers rang over the courthouse chairs. From house of justice to house of worship, secular to Jewish, civic to secret, the community of Devil's Lake gave up their courthouse for our high holidays. The county wouldn't set fall trial dates till they spoke to Herman, Morris, or Jake. On Rosh Hashanah, we'd move our portable ark from the Goldbergs' house to the courtroom bar. A faraway rabbi would travel in. We always hoped for a man who could sing when the courthouse was a synagogue. The only one judge in the room was God. From house of judges to house of a worship, secular to Jewish, civic to sacred, the community of Devil's Lake gave up their courthouse for our holidays. The Jews would come from miles around, leaving their farms to come and worship in town. We never knew how many would come. There had to be accommodation for everyone. The ladies planned while the service went on. They count all the guests and divvy them up. Each family knew which guests were there. They'd invite them over to dinner after prayer. From house of justice to house of worship, secular to Jewish, civic to sacred, the community of Devil's Lake gave up their courthouse for our high holidays. I'll be your missing word. hippie, my missing colors. I'll be your missing words. If you color me, I color you in too. Oh, 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 oh. I'll fill you in if you fill me in. I'll color you if you color me. I'll fill you in if you color me.
Can't see in the front of my feet. I'm tripping over a diamond ring, and I don't pick it up. Can't see in the front of my nose. I'm pulling at a door that says closed, and I don't stop.
This program is funded by the Minnesota Arts and Cultural Heritage Fund, with money from the vote of the people of Minnesota on November 4th, 2008. And by the members of Prairie Public.